We were talking about the Dr. Grant Robicheaux case. He and his girlfriend, Cerise Riley, who are accused of multiple felony sexual assaults and additional charges, additional suspects coming forward. And the reason that this became controversial is that Todd Spitzer had distributed copies of a sealed document, sealed search warrants to reporters covering the case. And Orange County District Attorney Tony Rackauckas said on Wednesday that Spitzer was, quote, had distributed, quote, extremely sensitive information about the rape victims and the defendants, and that this was a violation. So let's talk about both the case and the election with Orange County District Attorney Tony Rackauckas. Good morning, Mr. Rackauckas. How are you? Welcome back to the show.
I'm good. Good morning. How are you?
I'm fine. Appreciate you coming on with us. Let's start with the case itself. This is a peculiar case because it's believed anyway that Robicheaux and Riley may actually have assaulted maybe hundreds of people. It's, you know, people keep coming forward. How is it? Can you talk to us about how is it possible that so many people could have had encounters with this couple and it's taken this long for it to really come to the public's attention?
Well, you know, it takes place in social settings like restaurant bars. The cases that we have were at least to begin with, were the Newport Beach cases. And they're a couple. I mean, they're basically, a good looking couple. And the girlfriend goes and meets the victim, who's, a young, good looking lady who's going to become the victim. And it's disarming because, it's just that. I mean, it's just a young, good-looking young lady meeting the victim, talking and chatting and introducing the doctor. And pretty soon they're having drinks. And then next thing you know, those drinks are having a greater effect than an ordinary cocktail would have. And the victim then winds up being unconscious or close to it, taken to the defendant's home. And then all the sexual acts occur without the victim being able to consent to it because of the intoxication or being drugged. So it's the kind of thing that happens rather easily as far as the victims are concerned, the setting and that sort of thing. And it's also the kind of thing that women who are victimized by something like this don't really like to come forward and complain about. I think that they tend to be concerned that about a few things. One is they feel that maybe they went too far, maybe having drinks with the couple, maybe they went some distance toward consent. And of course, they're wrong about that because once you're a person's intoxicated,
right,
and can't consent.
Right, consent is no longer an issue if you're inebriated.
That's right.
Against your will.
But they
right.
have that. They have that. I think they have that guilty feeling, and also they don't want. They don't want their names and information spread around the news and that sort of thing. And so
it's embarrassing.
They have a lot of concern. Yeah, absolutely. They don't want to come forward. So I think that's one of the reasons that explains why a lot of women haven't come forward. But some have, certainly after this, after the press conference that we had, we started getting calls. And, we've had 100 or so calls now, and
wow.
we've been looking into those and investigating them, and they're not all calls from victims necessarily, but they're tips and leads and people who think they might be victims, and we've been looking into that, and now so we had five new good cases that we were prosecuting, and so that was the latest. That was the latest thing that we had was the addition of those five counts. Plus, we also decided that looking at it and, kind of considering and doing some research into how all this happened, that the intoxication gives rise not just to unconsented to sex, but unconsented to moving of the party from one place to another. And so this is a kidnapping as well as a rape.
We're talking with Orange County District Attorney Tony Rackauckas. Todd Spitzer was with us yesterday, and he made the allegation that this case took place in 2016, and charges weren't brought until 2018, and that this represented a failure on your part. How do you respond to that?
Well, we learned that there was such a case in towards the end of April of 2017, and once our office learned of that, we had an attorney, an investigator, start working on it with the Newport Beach Police to bring it forward. And I tell you, they worked diligently on this to bring it forward. Wound up in January of 2018 doing a search warrant, and that search warrant just developed a huge amount of material that had to be analyzed and decrypted and analyzed. There had to be follow-up search warrants, so it was a great deal of work. And when we finally got the case for our review from the Newport Beach Police, that was September 6th, and we filed the case 5 or 6 days later on September 11th. And we worked as quickly as we could to bring the case, and made arrest on the next day, the 12th. So I tell you the truth, I think we've been working pretty well. And I've looked back to see what our people have been doing, and they've been working diligently. I mean, we've had a good attorney, solid investigator working on this case, working with Newport, and trying to get this thing analyzed so we could bring it forward.
Release of the sealed information, which you have criticized Todd Spitzer for. Now, originally, as I understand it, this warrant was not sealed originally, and then was sealed subsequently. Is that correct?
It hadn't been sealed until it was brought to court to the judge, and he ordered it sealed in September of 2018. So. And there were two dates on it. There's September the 11th when it was ordered sealed, and then September the 18th when it was ordered sealed again. And it's very troubling. I mean, Supervisor Spitzer is an officer of the court. He's an attorney. He was in court during a discussion of the fact that these documents were sealed, and then not long after that, he was outside telling reporters that. While these documents had been sealed by the court, but in fact, he received them before they were sealed. So he was handing out pre-prepared copies to the press. So it's very destructive to the case, callous to the victims. I mean, this is to be honest with you, it's stunning that an attorney would do such a thing. He was doing it to make a point, the point that he's trying to make about that he thinks the timing of the case is bad and that sort of thing. But basically, he's just trying to build up his an argument for his candidacy for district attorney. So it's just unfortunate that he's done that. And I mean, it's discouraging to victims. Right shortly after that, we started getting calls from the victims in the case who want to know if their private information has been revealed or what happened here. And the ones that we've gotten the calls from so far have been ones that were not covered by the search warrant. But it's not just callous to them. It's also discouraging to new victims who might want to come forward and have the fear that this is going to be spread all over the news, that their information might be handed out to reporters. So so this is a tough situation. We're working on trying to remedy it the best we can. But it's like the judge said when he was when we were talking to him about trying to do something, he said, well, once all the bees escape from the beehive, you might be able to get some back, but you can't get them all. And that's the difficulty that we have here.
Tony Rackauckas is the Orange County District Attorney. He's on the ballot on November 6th. We appreciate you coming on and talking to us. Good luck on Election Day.
Thank you very much. I appreciate the time.
Okay.